with God, we can do this. Look at somebody and tell them, with God, we can do this. Whatever this represents, we can do this. If God be for us, who can be against us? Don't worry about the naysayers. That's just a test. And see how committed you are. Don't worry about the haters. That's just a test. To see if you're located in the center of His will. Don't worry about the distractors. Don't worry about the distractors. Set your face as a flint. Be courageous enough. Be hardened enough in your resolve and in your commitment to be true and loyal to God with a fierce loyalty and an uncompromising fidelity. Lord, I'm yours. Everything I am, everything I'm not, everything I have, I'm yours, Lord. I'm yours, Lord. Study me and see if I can be completely yours. The devil, watch this. Pastors, the devil will send distractors to church. Their main assignment and their main mission is to try to throw the pastor off point with God. I've had folk come to church, sit on the front seat, and I know they were dispatched and deputized by the devil, and all they were there for was to try to throw me off. They would sit there as I was preaching the gospel and have frowns and scowls on their face, as if you could be thrown off, I'm going to throw you off today, until I remember that when the enemy comes in like a flood, the Spirit of God. Against the enemy. I don't care what it is. I don't care how long you've been working at it. You help me say again, with God, we can do this. And we are better together, but if you want to personalize it, bring it home to your household, in your community, your job, your school campus, you will say with me again, with God, I can do this. Put your hands together. Put your hands together. For the Lord. Just bow your head right where you are. Come on, come on. We can't let a moment like this go by. I don't care what the enemy has said to you. I don't care how long your rap sheet is. What a long, dark past you have. You can be delivered. You can be saved. You can be set free. You can be resurrected. You confess with your mouth the Lord Jesus and believe in your heart that God has raised Him from the dead. You will be saved. For with the heart man believes unto righteousness, and with the mouth confession is made toward salvation. It shall come to pass, whoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. But how shall they call upon Him in whom they have not believed? And how shall they believe on Him of whom they have not heard? For faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. And I want you to know that the word that I've spoken unto you today has salvation in it, deliverance, resurrection power. You don't have to leave here in sin. The liberator is in the house. The liberator is in the house. Come on, just pray this prayer with me. Lord Jesus, I believe you to be the Savior. You died for me. You shed your blood. They hung you on the cross and then buried you, but on the third day you got up. Your word says that if I repent of my sins, if I'm sorry enough to quit sinning, if I repent of my sins, believe in you as the Savior, you would save me, you would forgive me. And now, Lord, I believe you to be the Savior. I believe you to give me a new lease on you. I believe that this could be the first day of the rest of my life. Okay.